Hey guys, a very warm welcome to all of you to Unacademy, which is India's largest online learning portal. And today we are going to do the chapter Tarot's Reward from your book Honeysuckle, and this is chapter number 3. So let's begin. As you all know, you can always ace your school with Unacademy's Plus subscription, which is now coming to you at a flat 10% discount if you use my code SWS10. And a little bit about me, dear learners. My name is Sweksha Sahai and I am your English educator. It is my passion to learn and teach English, and in fact, it's my passion to learn and teach languages. There are two other languages which I know apart from English, which are Spanish and French, and there are also a host of regional languages that I know. So yes, you can say that I love languages, and which is why I am teaching you English language today. All right, with that, let's begin this beautiful chapter, which is Tarot's Reward. This is a story about a thoughtful and loving son. He works hard to fulfill his parents' wishes and gets some unexpected help. So let's see what happens in Tarot's life and what is the reward that he gets for his hard work. Alright, so a young woodcutter named Taro lived with his mother and father on a lonely hillside. All day long he chopped wood in the forest. Though he worked very hard, he earned very little money. So poor Taro was a woodcutter and he would work really hard, but he would get very few pennies in return of his hard work. This made him sad, for he was a thoughtful son and wanted to give his old parents everything that they needed. So Taro earned very little money, but he wanted to give all good things that are present to his parents, but he was not able to because he earned peanuts. The wood cutting did not earn him a lot. So what happened one evening when Taro and his parents were sitting in a corner of their hut, a strong wind began to blow. It whistled through the cracks of the hut and everyone felt very cold. Suddenly Taro's father said, "I wish I had a cup of sake. It would warm me and do my old heart good." So Taro's poor father, who was really old and weak, was feeling very cold due to this cold wind which was blowing. And all he wanted was this warm drink called sake. This made Taro sadder. Because of this remark from his father, Taro became sadder, because the sake was an expensive drink and Taro could not afford it with the money that he was making currently. For the heartwarming drink called sake was very expensive. "How do I earn more money?" he asked himself. "How do I get a little sake for my poor old father?" He decided to work harder than before. So this poor Taro, he wanted to give, as you all know, all the good things to his parents. So what did he decide? He decided that he will work harder so that he can provide his poor father with some sake. Next morning, Taro jumped out of the bed earlier than usual and made his way to the forest. He chopped and cut as the sun climbed, and soon he was so warm that he had to take off his jacket. So he was working so hard that he had to take off his jacket even when it was really cold. His mouth was dry and his face was wet with sweat. "My poor father," he thought, "if only he was as warm as I." And with that, he began to chop even faster, thinking of the extra money he must earn to buy the sake to warm the old man's bones. So he worked hard and he worked harder, just because it was the only thing that in his mind that his mind was thinking was to buy some sake for his old father. And then suddenly Taro stopped chopping. Now let's see what happened. What was that sound he heard? Could it possibly be rushing water? Taro could not remember ever seeing or hearing a rushing stream in that part of the forest. He was thirsty. The axe dropped out of his hands and he ran in the direction of the sound. So what happened? Taro suddenly heard a rushing stream, and it was strange to him because he knew those parts really well. He came there to chop wood every day. But he had never heard any water gurgling in that part of the town. But suddenly the stream appeared, and Taro thought that he must listen to the sound and follow it so that he can reach the stream and get some fresh water. Taro saw a beautiful little waterfall behind a rock. Kneeling at a place where the water flowed quietly, he cupped a little water in his hand and put it to his lips. Was it water or was it sake? He tasted it again and again, and always it was the delicious sake instead of cold water. So what happened? Our poor little Taro got a fountain of sake, not just a bottle, but a fountain of sake. And let's see what he does next. Taro quickly filled the pitcher he had with him and hurried home. The old man was delighted with the sake. After only one swallow of liquid, he stopped shivering and did a little dance in the middle of the floor. This afternoon, a neighbor stopped by for a visit. A neighbor stopped by for a visit. Taro's father politely ordered her a cup of sake. The lady drank it and greedily and thanked the old man. Then Taro told her the story of the magic waterfall. Thanking them for the delicious drink, she left in a hurry. So this woman, she drank some sake and then she thanked this man and she left in a big hurry. By nightfall, she had spread the story throughout the whole village. So just by evening, the entire village knew that our poor Taro found a fountain of sake. That evening, there was a long procession of visitors to the woodcutter's house. Each man heard the story of the waterfall and took a sip of sake. In less than an hour, the pitcher was empty. Next morning, Taro started for work even earlier than the morning before. He carried with him the largest pitcher he owned, for he intended first of all to go to the waterfall. When he reached it, he found to his great surprise all his neighbors there. So as you know, that the news was spread throughout the village by the woman. And when Taro reached the waterfall, the entire neighborhood was there trying to get the sake. They were carrying pitchers, jars, buckets, anything they could find to hold the magic sake. Then one villager knelt and held his mouth under the waterfall to drink. He drank again and again and then shouted angrily, "Water! Nothing but water!" Others also cried, but there was no sake, only cold water. "We have been tricked," shouted the villagers. "Where is Taro? Let us drown him in this waterfall." But Taro had been wise enough to slip behind a rock when he saw how things were going. He was nowhere to be found. So Taro, who was a wise guy also, apart from being hardworking, he knew that these villagers will be angry upon not finding sake in the waterfall. So he hid behind the rocks so that no one harms him. Okay, and then muttering their anger and disappointment, the villagers left the place one by one. Taro came out from the hiding place. Was it true? He wondered. Was the sake a dream? Once more, he got a little liquid in his hand and put it to his lips. It was the same fine sake. To the thoughtful son, the magic waterfall gave delicious sake. To everyone else, it gave only cold water. The story of Taro and his magic waterfall reached the Emperor of Japan. He sent for the young woodcutter and rewarded him with 20 pieces of gold for having been so good and kind. Then he named the most beautiful fountain in the city after Taro. This, said the emperor, was to encourage all children to honor and obey their parents. And this is a Japanese story which was retold. And now that we have reached the end of this chapter and we have understood how hardworking was Taro and how it was rewarded by a magical sake waterfall, sake fall. So let's look at the question answers. Why did Taro run in the direction of the stream? Taro ran in the direction of the stream because he had never heard water flow in that part of the town. So he was amazed, and that is why he ran in the direction of the stream. How did Taro's father show his happiness after drinking sake? So after drinking sake, as we saw in the chapter, Taro's father did a little dance in the middle of the floor. Why did the waterfall give Taro sake and others water? Well, the waterfall was a magical one, and it rewarded hard work and thoughtfulness of the hardworking Taro. Why did the villagers want to drown Taro? Let me just grab some water. So, why did the villagers want to drown Taro? The villagers wanted to drown Taro because they were disappointed upon finding water in the waterfall. Because they were expecting sake, but there was only water for everybody else, and sake was only there for Taro. Why did the emperor reward Taro? So the emperor rewarded Taro because he was so good and kind, and he wanted him to be an example for the rest of the children. Mark the correct answer. Taro earned very little money because he didn't work hard enough. The villagers didn't need wood, and the price of wood was very low. So it will be number 3. The price of wood was very low. Taro decided to earn extra money to live more comfortable life, to buy his old father some sake, or to repair the cracks in the hut. So it will be number 2. To buy his old father some sake. Number 3. The neighbor left Taro's hut in a hurry because she was delighted with the drink. She was astonished to hear Taro's story, and she wanted to tell the whole village about the waterfall. So it will obviously be number 3, which is she wanted to tell the whole village about the waterfall. So that brings us to the end of this question answer session and the end of the discussion of this chapter. Hopefully you understood the chapter, and this revision will help you get great marks in your exam. Now let's look at the Anna Academy's Plus subscription features. You can learn in a live class from India's top educators. There's regular doubt clearing and answer writing sessions. There are exhaustive coverage of syllabus. Mentorship and guidance is available. The study material are given to you in a PDF format. Practice test and live test series is also there. And of course, there are batch courses. The pricing for the Unacademy's Plus subscription is on the screen right now, and you can use my code SWS10 to get a handsome discount of 10% on this pricing. And let's see what is the amazing iconic subscription. You get personal mentorship, you get live doubt solving, there's weekly report, there is parent connect, there is study planner, and you also have all the benefits of the Plus subscription. The pricing is on the screen, and as you all know, you can get a flat 10% discount if you use my code SWS10. So what are you waiting for, guys? Go ahead, download the Unacademy app from Google Store, or iPhone users can download it as well. So that brings us to the end of this chapter, but I'll be back again with the chapter number 4. Until then, please like, share and subscribe to our channel. Also, do not forget to press the bell icon so that you can get all the updates from our channel and you never ever miss a class from us. Thanks a lot for watching this video and joining us today. Have a great day ahead. Bye bye, guys.